by Courtmaster at 50-1, Lucia Borrowdale. Last option, 6-4 chance Fiona Needham. Miller the Rags at 66-1, Neil King. Racky Crazy at 16-1, Ashley Farrant. Gallant's Delight is a 7-1 chance, the mount of Andrew Robson. Grimley Gale is a 5-4 favourite, Julian Pritchard. And Hilton's Down Less at 16-1, Clive Mulhall. Grimley Gale at 5-4, last option at 6-4. And then this break in the betting to Gallant's Delight at 7, 16-1. Bar the way then for this Horse and Hound Cup with 21 fences in front of them and about 2.5 circuits to cover, and it's Grimley Gale, runner-up last year, that takes an early lead as they take the first from Courtmaster. Mistake at the first by Gallant's Delight there. The rider had to sit pretty tight, Andrew Robson, as they now continue towards an open ditch. Fence number two, Grimley Gale. Jumped it well from Courtmaster in second. Then Miller the Rags in third from Gallant's Delight. Last option is settled by Fiona Needham back in fifth place from Hilton's Town Lass. And finally, in last place is Racky Crazy. Racky Crazy running for Martin Pipe today, as was the case here last night in a Hunter Chase. Two horses there that hitherto had not been professionally trained were switched very late. A loophole of the rules, one for Paul Nichols and one for Martin Pipe, and the same is true of Martin, who's now taken over Racky Crazy here. Of course, a lot of heated competition at the moment as Messrs Pipe and Nichols chase the Trainers' Championship. Down the straight they go, on towards fence number four, Grimley Gale, still cutting out the pace. Courtmaster and then Miller the Rags, last option towards the wide outside, also for Breastgirth. And then Gallant's Delight as they take the next. It'll be the last in another couple of circuits time. Racky Crazy one from last, and then finally Hilton's Town Lass. Grimley Gale's rider, Julian Pritchard, his cap's just slipped back a little bit. Julian's well clear in the point-to-point men's championship this season. Rides very well. Courtmaster in second. And then Miller the Rags as they approach the plain fence just passing the stands. Last option towards the outside. Very big jump there by Grimley Gale. Met it very well indeed. She's a formidable mare between the flags. Got an impressive win record. She's won 5 out of 7 starts under rules as well. So this is a really smart performer, Grimley Gale. Miller the Rags in second. Last option towards the outside, just hanging a little bit, last option under Fiona Needham, popped over that well enough, just hanging to the right, left of picture at the moment, last option. So continue now towards another open ditch. Well, they're all jumping all right at the moment. Oaks, Grimley Gale making the running, and last option just hanging slightly, isn't he?
He is possibly a little bit. I think that Fiona's probably decided to steer around the outside, give him plenty of daylight. Maybe hanging just a bit, but I think it's by design. On the other hand, Grimley Gale has so far been giving an exhibition. I hope I don't spell her fate, but she's been jumping quite beautifully with Middle of the Rags. Both those caps have come off. Grimley Gale then caused Julian Pritchard to call a bit of a cab. But, as you say, they're jumping pretty well. These fences aren't really that much bigger than point-to-points. And Grimley Gale, oh dear!
That's Courtmaster has gone there, John.
Fatal to talk about good jumping.
Yes, Grimley Gale left in front. Courtmaster, you see the horse seems all right. Try and update you on the rider, who's getting to her feet now, Lucia Borrowdale, as they meanwhile jump the next plain one down the back. And it's Grimley Gale that continues to make the running. From last option now back on the inside into second place from Miller the Rags. So as they make the turn out of the back straight once again, they've got just over a circuit to cover then in this 41st running of the Horse and Hound Cup. And it's Grimley Gale by about 4 lengths to last option, her market rival chasing in second place as they approach this next one. Last option wasn't too clever at that. And then behind them, Racky Crazy on the inside of Miller the Rags, followed by Hilton's Town Lass and Gallant's Delight. Over the next, Grimley Gale, still jumping boldly in front. Last option in second place. third in the Cheltenham Fox Hunters last option, winner of his last two starts. In third then is Mill of the Rags, Hiltonstown Lad, Lass, and then Gallant's Delight and Racky Crazy as they bunch up passing the stands, heading towards this next plain one. And the challenger's mounting to the leader, Grimley Gale, as she approaches this next plain one. And she was very bold again then there, and it's just keeping her in front. Racky Crazy very nearly ran out on the inside, red and white hoop sleeve jacket, having jumped away to the left and now drops to last place. They swing away then along the side of the course, and it's Grimley Gale from Gallant's Delight who's moved up into second on the inside of last option as they approach this next plain one. The three leaders land safely. Mill of the Rags over in fourth from Hiltonstown Lass, who's now being chased along, and Racky Crazy at the back of the pack ahead as they head towards the next open ditch. Grimley Gale and last option ranging alongside, but Grimley Gale was slightly quicker over the fence. In third is Gallant's Delight, two or three lengths to Hiltonstown Lass. Racky Crazy rallying a bit, and Mill of the Rags drops back to be last now. Well, can they catch this leader, Grimley Gale? She's run a tremendous race from the front so far. They've got five fences left to jump as they turn into the back straight and on towards the next plain one. Grimley Gale by three lengths to last option. Grimley Gale and Julian Pritchard, but a good jump there, but a good jump also in second by last option. Got him a little bit closer on landing. They're getting away from Gallant's Delight and Hiltonstown Lass as they race now towards the final open ditch. And it's Grimley Gale, beaten by Teton Mill in this race 12 months ago, trying to go one better, has a 2.5 length lead over last option, who's shaken up quite vigorously now in second place by Fiona Needham as they race towards the third last, the last in the back straight. Grimley Gale got it a bit tight this time, but was clever at it. Last option has got two or three lengths to make up as they round the final turn. They're a long way clear of Hiltonstown Lass and then Gallant's Delight, and Grimley Gale kicks again in front from last option as they make the final corner with two fences in front of them in the Horse and Hound Cup. And it's Grimley Gale going great guns. Last option trying hard to ped back the deficit in second place. At the second last, Grimley Gale over again, safe and sound. Last option hasn't given in yet, but it's still a big task as they head towards the final fence. Grimley Gale has made every yard of the running, didn't get very high, neither did last option, but last option closed a little bit, but on the run for home. Grimley Gale still got plenty left in the tank and forges away. It's Grimley Gale and Julian Pritchard who win the Horse and Hound Cup. In second place, last option chased valiantly all the way. They're a long way clear of Hiltonstown Lass, and then behind Hiltonstown Lass is Mill of the Rags. And looking back there, the only four finishers, because Racky Crazy has been pulled up and Gallant's Delight came to grief at the final fence. Gallant's Delight, the horse, is all right. The rider is sitting up, Andrew Robson. Well, Grimley Gale, beaten hollow by Teton Mill in this race 12 months ago. Had nothing of that calibre in opposition this afternoon and has deservedly gone one better with a fine, bold display of front favourite. 5-4 favourite and winner. Second, number two, last option at 6-4. And third, number seven, Hiltonstown Lass at 16-1.